sensitivity and love of the logo. In their lower aspect, these centers are known as the centers of generation and the solar plexus. They are transmuted as evolution proceeds into the firm and mark centers. Then, in a dual synthesis, we will pass on into the third system, that in which the power aspect is developed and the head center will be completed. This achieved, our logos has triumphed and measured up to the sixth cosmic initiation, just as we should measure up and up into the fourth. The ray of concrete science has a peculiar relationship to the animal kingdom, in that it is the ray that governs the merging of that kingdom into the human. The planet, Venus, in her fifth round, gave the impetus which produced the spark of mind in animal man of that well known. It is also the fifth ray, and heaven. Interesting connection with the fifth law of causation. We might study, too, with profit, the analogy that can be seen between these factors and the fifth moon race, a race of peculiarly strong development of the concrete mind. The law of analogy always holds good. With this as a basis, the three laws of the personality become replete with life, and summed up in the well-known term, the law of rebirth and death in the three worlds. The fifth law governs a fixed point in the personality, that is the fifth principle. THOUGHTANTFIRELEMENTALS 591. The law of love in the astral body also has its points for consideration. There is a direct link between the astral body, love in the personality, the unique deities of love in the triad, and the monads of love. Later on, this will be understood more fully, but it is the main channel for the basic law of the system, love. Three points mark periods of completion, and likewise starting points for present immersion of life of the evolving monad from the personality to the triad, from the triad to the monad, from the monad back again to its source. 5. The law of fixation. This is the governing law of the mental plane, finding its greater correspondence in the law of karma on cosmic mental levels. As a man thinks, so is he, according to his thoughts or his desires and acts, and so results the future. He gives it for himself the result of karma. The word, fixation, is chosen for two purposes. The word implies the capacity of the thinker to shape his own destiny, and secondly because the word implies a stabilizing idea, for inevitably progress is, the ego evolves the faculty of forming definite concrete thought forms, and, in these vagaryotics, of subduing the fluctuations of the astral body. This law of the fifth, our mental plane, is one of the most important laws in which we have to give at any time, and it will find its most complete demonstration in the next, our fifth round. In relation to this fourth round, the following facts may be gathered about its working. It is the law under which the evolving personality builds up, during the course of many lives, the causal body, it fixes the matter entering in that body, placed there by the man as the ages slip away, and crystallizes it. The basic force initiation of crystallization is complete, and the inevitable shattering that is the result of crystallization in all forms takes place, setting the 592 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Indwelling life free for further progress. All forms are but hindrances and limitations, and ultimately operates. This law governs the crystallization of all forms prior to their shattering in the process of evolution. It governs the time of rebirth, being one of the subsidiary branches of the law of karma. Each of the seven subsidiary laws is linked to one of the cosmic laws, or with the Syrian law of karma. Consciousness of the cosmic mental plane is the logo of attainment, and the Syrian logo is our solar logo, what the human ego is and personality. The law of karma, or cosmic fixation, is the law of the cosmic mental plane, and controls the corresponding law in our system. In the fifth round, this law will act as the divider, temporarily crystallizing and fixing into two great classes of the human monad, as they are. One group then containing those who will reach the goal, will pass gradually out from under the domination of this law, and will come under the law of magnetic control. Another will remain under the law of the static position, until in a later period a fresh opportunity will come. Manvantara, and in its fifth period, will come the chance for the humans awaited, when they can again swing into the current of evolution and the imprisoned spirits may mount again towards their source. In an occult sense, this law is first the one that will create the most intimate concern. It plays an important part in the hand of the Lords of Flame, and is one of their main factors in controlling the great flows. Note here an interesting fact, that Venus is the sixth planet that's appearing to the second and is in TANDFIRELEMENTALS 593. Fifth round, and hence is ahead of us along every line. Quality of love, static temporarily, but necessarily so when viewed from the standpoint of the time, the great leader. On the path of integration, this law again works with the permanent atoms in the three worlds, with the building any material around those atoms, in connection with the building devas of the reincarnating ego. The devas of the mother aspect, reincarnating jivas of the sun aspect, give the two of them one, and the result is the divine hermaphrodite standpoint 846. The law of love, it is not easy, in this brief digest, to approach the tremendous problem of the place love plays in the evolving scheme of things as understood by three-dimensional man. A treatise could be written on the subject, and yet leave it unexhausted. Much light comes as we can ponder deeply on the three expressions of love. Love in the personality, love in the ego, and love in the monad. Love in the personality gradually develops through the stages of love of self, pure and simple and entirely selfish, to love of family and friends, to love of men and women, until it arrives at the stage of love of humanity or group love consciousness, which is the predominant characteristic of the ego. A master of compassion loves, suffers with, and remains with kind and thicker skin. Love in environment. Patriotism gives place later to love of humanity. Often humanity is exemplified in one of the great ones. The astral plane is, at the present time, the most important for us, for in desire not corrected or transmuted line of difference between the personal consciousness and that of the ego 0.85 in the 16th.
Thank you.
works at this time in line with the seventh law. In a mysterious way, this law is the reverse side of the first, or the law of vibration. It is Vulcan and Neptune in opposition, which is as yet an almost incomprehensible thing for us. The densest form of expression on the physical plane is after all the form of synthesis, just as the rarest form of expression on the highest plane of the unity is synthesis of the finer kind. One is the synthesis of matter, and the other the synthesis of light. This law governs the seventh chain in each scheme, each chain having achieved the fullest expression possible in the scheme, comes under the law of death, and expiration and disintegration supervenes. In a cosmic sense and analogy, it is the law that governs the coming in of Pralaya at the end of the system. It is the law that shatters the cross of the cosmic night, and places the form of the Christ within the T for a period of time. The principle of mutation. In concluding the above information about the laws, it is needful that we all recognize the extreme danger of dogmatizing about these matters, and the risk of laying down hard and fast rules. Much must remain unexplained and untouched, and much also is served to raise only questions in our minds. Comprehension is as yet impossible. In Telford's dimensional sight as ours, it will scarcely be possible for us to do more than minute, and get a passing vision of the complexity and the interweaving in the system. It is not easy for us to do more than grip as a mental concept the fact that the rain, seas, planets, chains, rounds, races and laws form the unit, seen from the angle of human vision and conclusion seems unimaginable, and that the abyss. The solution to be so hidden is to be useless, yet, seen from the angle of the world sight. 598 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. The whole moves in unison, and is geometrically accurate. In order to give some idea of the complexity of the arrangement, I would like here to point out that the rays themselves circulate the law of karma controlling the interweaving. For instance, ray I may pass around a scheme if it is the paramount ray of the scheme with it. First suffering manifesting in a chain, its second in a round, its third in a world period, its fourth in a world race, its fifth in a sub-race, and its sixth in a branch race. I give this in illustration, and not as a statement of a fact in present manifestation. This gives us some idea of the vastness of the process, and of its wonderful beauty. It is impossible for us, sweeping through on some one ray, to visualize or in any way to apprehend this beauty, yet, to those on higher levels and with a wider range of vision, the gorgeousness of the design is apparent. This complexity is first very much increased because we do not yet understand the principle governing this mutation. Nor is it possible for even the highest human mind in the three worlds to be more than sense and approximate that principle. By mutation I mean the fact that there is a constant changing and shifting, and endless interweaving and interlocking, and a ceaseless ebb and flow, and a dramatic interplay of the forces that stand for the dual synthesis of spirit and matter. There is constant rotation in the rays and planes, in there. Relative immediately. also demonstrates the divine magnitude of the scheme with its magnificent intricacies. The reason the fourth is a major round is because in this round two things happened. A spark of mind was implanted in the door open from the animal human into the human. And later, another door opened onto the path leading from the human kingdom into the spiritual again a dual reason. The fifth round is a major round because it marks a point in evolution where those who will achieve the goal and those who will not are sharply differentiated into two groups. The seventh is a major round because it marks emerging of the two evolutions, the human and the diva. Major world races are chosen under the law of correspondence. In the third world race came the third outpouring, emerging in the point of contact between the spiritual triad and the lower quaternary. The fifth world race marks a point where higher and lower manas approximate, and where the concrete mind, meeting its highest development of this round, gives place to the intuition from above. Here again we have a twofold reason. The seventh wood race again demonstrates low attainment, love and activity, the basis of the third system of lower power. The three major race, being dual, are their own sufficient explanation. They are at present the mode of expression of the three aspects, and demonstrate under their appropriate logoi, who manipulate world affairs through the three departments, of which the rulers on our planet are the Lord Maitreya, the Mani, and the Mahachohan. The three major planes demonstrate easily their unique position. On plane 2 we have the home of the monads of love. On plane 5 we find the habitat of their reflection, the reincarnating egos, and 600 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. On the physical plane we find the working out of extensive time with the life of the spirit. This principle of mutation governs every department in the law of correspondences, and certain things can be stated with regard to physics, and its component parts that can be found illuminating if we remember that they are facts for the present. Let me again illustrate. You have been told that the three major rays at this time are the first, the second, and the seventh. Later, the rays now major may become subsidiary, and others take their place, though for this solar system the second ray, being the synthetic ray, will always be a major ray. Perhaps we can here get a hint on this ray principle, though we must be careful not to draw it out to too fine a conclusion. For this system the major rays will always be a